My name's Michelle and I'm a science and maths teacher at St Mary's Star of the Sea College. It's a Catholic all-girls school located right on the beach in Wollongong. My Year 8 class is a mixed ability class, so all the girls in it range from students that exceed in their learning, that are above their level, and I also have students that are on specific educational lesson plans that need a lot of extra support and help. Science by doing is basically the core of what I teach. So it provides the lesson structures. It gives a lesson plan of potentially how you could run a particular lesson. The learning outcome for this lesson was basically to define what properties make up a solid, liquid, and a gas. What do you think this is?
Solid.
Oh, it's silly putty. And it's falling between my hands. Why do you think it's a solid?
Because you can grab it.
Yeah.
You can just...
You can grab it with your hands?
Yeah.
How about... But you can have thick liquids. All right. At the end of the lesson, what you're going to tell me is with absolute certainty what you think the state of this is. Maybe it's a solid. Maybe it's a liquid. Maybe it's a gas. So that kind of engaged them at the beginning of the lesson. But in order to tell me what it is, we need to figure out what properties solids, liquids, and gases have. So what we're going to do is we're going to do an investigation. So in groups, we are going to look at the volume of solids, liquids, gases, the shape of solids, liquids, and gases, and the compressibility of solids, liquids, and gases. And each group is going to investigate one state of matter. And you can use any piece of equipment you want here. Now I want you to squeeze as hard as you can. Does it squish? No. So can you compress it? No. So let's pop that down in our tables. So what's the volume of the liquid that's inside here?
30
mils. What do you think will happen if I put it in this measuring cylinder?
It will change because that one is thinner.
It'll change what?
It'll change shape.
It'll change shape?
Touch it. Just leave it in. See how it's fogging up? See how it's
turning? Put your finger on there and...
Yeah, go. Okay. We can't compress them anymore.
Their notebooks are very personal to them. I don't generally write notes up on the board and they copy it down word for word. They are in charge of their own note taking. So the extent of what they've written down and how they've articulated what they want in their notebooks can also give me a good understanding of where their learning is up to. And now keep squishing. Can you squish just the solid?
No.
No. So what can you say about its compressibility? It doesn't compress. By working in small groups, all students were able to contribute to the investigation and were able to see what was happening. And then we worked in larger groups where we could really focus in on making sure our experiment was correct and valid.
The volume can change depending on whether, like, you can add more to it or take less out.
Yeah, the only time that it doesn't change unless you add or take away.
Like, to almost half the original size. And we did that by, like, capturing some steam from boiled water and putting it into one of these tubes, and then we just put our finger on the end and
pushed it, and it compressed. They needed to articulate using the results that they had in their investigation what state silly putty was in. What I want you to do is have a look back at all the things you wrote down about solids, liquids, and gases, and I'll come around and give you an egg full of it, and you can discuss with your group what you think it is. What's happened to it?
It's molded into the
shape. It's molded into the shape. Can you compress it?
Compress it.
So what do you think it is?
It's a liquid.
Good job. So by them coming up with their own rules and then deciding from their own rules that they set what a solid and a liquid and a gas were, they're a lot more enthusiastic and engaged and more likely to remember that information in the long run.